We're live from Clemson, the biggest little town in South Carolina. We got a great college football matchup coming your way. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Florida has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Well, the crowd has been waiting for him all day. Lawrence's big playability about to be on display in front of the home crowd here. He's set to take his first snap as he brings the offense out, Kurt.
And, Brad, this kid's reputation precedes him. The entire offense is designed around him. As his performance goes, so will his team. So let's see what he can do in front of this big crowd. Just a complete leader. And I think the quarterback that time didn't even see the linebacker. I think he was so focused downfield trying to read the safeties in the secondary that by the time he came to his receiver that was being guarded by the linebacker, I don't think he saw him. The linebacker made a good play to be able to knock that ball away.
And he's tackled right away.
I like how the offense is using the pass to get him involved. He's explosive, and you just want to get the ball in his hands.
Hit before it could go anywhere. So a nice little pitch and catch there, and that'll give the offense a first down.
That was a very good looking pass play to get more than enough yards to move the chains.
They'll bring him down around the 49-yard line.
Nothing doing that time. Defender stayed home, blocking wasn't there, and down he went.
It's second down and 11 to go. Ball on the 49. Fires that quickly to the tailback. And he's taken down at the 42-yard line. Chucks it downfield. And got him! What a play, and that'll set up a first and goal.
You know, I think the quarterback did a really good job here of sensing pressure before the ball was snapped. And I think it allowed him to change the protection at the line of scrimmage. When he changed that protection, the offensive line knew the blitz was coming. That allowed them to be able to pick up the blitzers, and then the quarterback could sit back there and make the right read. But it all started with the recognition from the quarterback, recognizing blitz, making the right check at the line, and then being able to make a good throw downfield.
He is drilled at the two.
Roger, Roger! Mike 51.
And he's tackled at the 1 yard line. A 2 yard run by the halfback.
Reset, cut right. Mike 28. So we got man.
Gotta be careful of a pass play with this defense. Tacks on the extra point. A 10-play, 75-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
The score now, 7-0. He's to the 20. Fumble. It's picked up. And he's tackled at the 23.
The last time we saw this offense on the field, they drove the length of the field. And you think back to what that defensive coordinator tried to do. He tried to change some things up, but nothing seemed to work. It's going to be interesting to see how he can have an impact on this drive.
Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that.
First and 15 now. Ball on the 28. He throws it. He almost had it, but it's incomplete. Clemson is up a score. Throws and it's knocked away. It's third down and 15 to go. Ball on the 28-yard line.
51, Mike. Mike, 51. Come on, baby. I'm coming.
He's looking for six. What a pick.
Oh, boy. I bet he knew as soon as he released that football that he shouldn't have made the throw. And that's the thing. When you're under that kind of pressure, it takes away that one split second you need to scan the area so you know where it's a safe throw.
And down he goes at the 16-yard line. Second down now, 14 to go. Ball on their own 16. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. Pierce gets 3 yards on the carry. Setting up blockers, the running back's got it on the screen. Tackle at the 21. Kendrick, the return man. He's taken down at the 43. Offense comes back out looking to improve from their last effort.
He's got a lot of time to forget about that last pick. He's just got to stick to the game plan.
Loose football. Picks up the loose ball. He's at the 40. He gets to about the 34-yard line. And that's exactly what this defense was looking for.
Yeah, that fumble gives these guys some added life. Now let's see if they can capitalize off of it.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
Looking for his man, incomplete. Well, he tried to thread the needle with that pass.
Well, here the quarterback makes a poor decision throwing into coverage. Needs to look at his progression and find the second and third receiver.
Second and 10. Ball on the 34-yard line. He's taken down right around the 20. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Well, this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
Brought down around the 17-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide. Fires it out. He's tackled at the 5. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Touchdown, Florida!
Things can get pretty fierce in this territory, but they look totally in control there.
The extra point to tie this game up. He makes the PAT. Florida, yet set to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So can the defense match their effort from the last drive with another takeaway?
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
Quick throw, tackle made at the 32-yard line. Tackled after a decent pickup. They hand it off again. Runs outside for a nice gain. And he tackles him hard at the 41-yard line. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Quick pass. He's knocked out of bounds at the 38-yard line. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. A nice looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
From the 27-yard line, it's first down. They make the stop at the 16. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
Caught, and big hit there to stop it. Decent run up the gut. 4 yards there on the old quarterback keeper. They'll bring him down at about the 7-yard line. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. Somebody jumped early down there.
Just a minute lapse, but it's going to cost him 5 yards.
Clemson could take the lead with this field goal. It's up, and he's got it.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Clement fields it at the 2. And he's taken down at the 29-yard line.
Brad, everywhere we go when we travel over the country, people want to talk about offense. Oh, the spread, or the pistol, hurry up, tempo offense, and points. It's nice to watch a team that prides itself on playing great defense. And when it's all said and done, the teams that advance and get to the important bowl games and do well in the postseason are teams that have this kind of defense.
He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. Pickup of a yard for the tailback.
You have to like how this linebacker was able to move up quickly and bring down the ball carrier for a short gain. Nice stop by the junior.
And a quick throw. And he's immediately tackled. Run, and he's brought down. On the pitch, look out, loose ball. Looks like a defensive lineman might have it, and he does.
Boy, the end really showed some explosiveness there in getting to the loose ball.
They picked up 3 points on their last possession, and they've got great field position to work from here. Clemson has a 3-point lead. He makes it to the 28-yard line. zips it out to the right. Great catch there before they can knock him out of bounds.
Well, they found some seams in the coverage there. Let's see if the defense makes any adjustments to counter.
And he's hit immediately. Touchdown, Tigers! No need to pitch it as the quarterback's able to run it in.
I'll tell you what, when you're a quarterback and the goal line is right there, it's pretty hard to pitch the ball when you think you can get in. That's a smart decision to keep it for the score.
And he adds the extra point. As his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. From his own goal line. And down he goes at the 27. A long ways yet to go, but at the end of one, the Tigers with a 10-point lead. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. Here comes the offense. No doubt looking to take better care of the ball on this drive.
You don't change your philosophy after one play. They'll be out doing the same thing as before, just with better awareness.
What a tackle. That was going to be a touchdown. Nice play.
Good job here by the quarterback is staying with his receiver, and the receiver stays with the route because he knows his quarterback has the arm strength to get it there.
Brought down in the open field. He makes his way out to about the 9. Touchdown, Gators! Here's the point after to try to cut this to a 3-point game. He splits the uprights with the extra point. McPherson gets set to kick this one away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 24. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Clemson is up a field goal. Quick throw to the tight end. And he's taken down at the 30. There. Under heavy pressure. He gets rid of this one, so that'll make it fourth down.
It was a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
Clement is the deep man awaiting the return. And he's tackled at the 44-yard line. The offense will be hoping they can move the ball as well as they did on their last drive.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, then you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
He laterals. Nice run there.
Man left. Go down.
He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. With a sack.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long. Just throws this one away. Kendrick, back to return it. Lawrence's ability at that quarterback spot, we all knew about that, Kirk, and we thought he was going to have a good game. He's not disappointing us at all. We're closing in on halftime, and right now he's having an effect on the entire game and especially on his team.
Yeah, and Brad, he's really just sparked this entire offense, and I think his success has a lot to do with the momentum that this team's been able to enjoy. And this is exactly what the coaching staff have counted on, is his ability to lead this team and make plays like this to be able to lead them to a victory. It takes a special player to be able to do it, and so far we've seen that from him.
It's second and 12. Ball on the 21-yard line. Clemson is up by three. Short pass, middle of the field. And down he goes at the 36. Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that. To his tailback again. Tackle right around the 46-yard line. And he just gets rid of it. Grimes is back deep to return the punt. Makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. Not sure what the flag is about here. Let's go down to the field and find out. Flipping is the call, and now they'll have to find a way to make up those yards right here. First and 10. Ball on the 13. Get there.
Brad, look at the defensive coordinator down on the sideline. He's wiping his brow down there. They just caught a big break that time because the quarterback just overthrew the ball.
Hand off, and he's met in the backfield. It's third down, 12 to go. Ball on the 11. The grab past the marker. Across midfield. At the 30. To the 20. Touchdown saving tackle, but it leaves him with a first and goal.
Huge play for both the quarterback and receiver, but it all starts with the big fellas up front who provided the time to get the quarterback a chance to throw.
Never want to see a kid down on the field after a play. Not sure what happened, but hopefully it's nothing serious. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receivers. Room around the corner. Touchdown, Florida! And he hits the PAT. A five-play, 88-yard drive, and they get it in for seven.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Tigers, quarterback Kirk, he has done his job. Unfortunately, there's 22 guys on a team, and one guy's doing a great job, the other 21 aren't so much.
Yeah, it's not going the way they had hoped or planned. Right now, you're right, the quarterback's doing what he needs to do to be able to move the ball, but the running backs, the wide receivers, the offensive line, the entire group, they've got to do a better job right now. Look at that scoreboard. They've got to be really frustrated to think that they're down. Now, they still have time to get back in the game, and we'll see if they can adjust their mental mindset.
Quarterback stats are one thing. Winning the game is what's more important. Just throws this one away. It's second and 10. Ball on the 39. The Gators' wide receiver went out with that injury. He was a key part of their offense, and they're going to have to try to find a way to replace him. It's not going to be easy. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Throws it out there, and they couldn't hook up on that one. Grimes awaiting the return. He's taken down at the 38.
I think we saw the effects of what a long drive can do to a defense the last time this offense was out on the field. They took that football and drove the length of the field to put points up on the board. And I think it really started to affect not only just the psyche of this defense, but maybe even the conditioning where they started to get a little bit fatigued.
Florida holds a four-point lead. Made around the 36-yard line. He gets sacked on the play. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. Kick is up, and it's off the crossbar. No good. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
That's a great tackle at the 29. Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. Played a half of football. The Gators lead it by four.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Keith Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. This game's been everything we anticipated it being, each team matching each other blow for blow, just a one-possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two games match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is, and it's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground. And which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
That's it for us here in the studio. What are you going to do in the second half while the game's going on?
Yeah, I'm
going to
kick back and watch all these monitors.
We'll keep you up to date on everything going on around the country right now. Time for the second half with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter.
Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 20.
The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Florida is up by four. And he hauls it in. He's taken down at the 25. Copeland picks up around 5 yards with that catch. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And they make the stop
right around the 44-yard line.
This quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
Up the middle for a nice game.
Man left, man left. Four down. 47 mark.
They'll bring him down at the 43-yard line. At the 41.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Florida is up four. Fires incomplete to the fullback. They call on the kicker for a long field goal. Kicks away. No good. He pushed it to the right. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. And he makes it out to about the 41-yard line. Midfield. He's tackled around the 44-yard line. And now he's got room to run. Brought down at about the 31. Run to the left there. Nice run there as they work the outside. Give it off here, and they'll get him in the backfield. So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. He gets it up, and he just drilled it from long range. Looks ready to kick this one off. Clement fields it at the one. He's tackled at the 26-yard line.
Florida's offense was rolling along earlier, and now they have gone ice cold in the third quarter.
Brad, they almost look like a different team. It's like they've come out of the locker room a little bit flat here in the second half. We'll see if they can have something happen, something to spark them and maybe get their mojo going before they end up losing this ballgame.
Florida, up a point. And he is drilled at the 40. Fires out to his receiver, and he's taken down at the 48-yard line. Quick throw out to the receiver, and they got him for a loss. Third down now, and they need to get it out to the 50. The middle. Going over the middle, intercepted. And he's tackled at the 50. Good job to pick that ball off.
He did a great job at getting in that passing lane and coming away with the ball.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 50-yard line. And down he goes, around the 47-yard line. Level at the 46-yard line. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. He gets hit out of bounds around the 42-yard line. He's going to try to coffin corner this one. Punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. The offense will take the field, hoping for a better result than their last drive.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
He goes out of bounds, right around the 24-yard line. Florida with a one-point lead. At the 37.
Keep 15. Keep 15. Watch the slant. Watch the slant.
Gets it out quickly. And he shoved out of bounds right around the 42-yard line. Gains his way to midfield. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Let's go, D. Let's go, D.
Tackled after a decent pickup. First and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line. Somebody jumped early down there.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
Fights forward to about the 43. Davis gets about a yard on the play. Tackle made at the 29-yard line. Florida is up one. Makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. It's up, and he nails the long field goal. Pearson gets set to kick this one away. He'll take it from the two. They'll bring him down at the 31-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Gets out to about the 31. He unloads it.
They can't connect. Incomplete. Well, I think he came down with it, but from up in the booth, it's hard to tell. So the referee is going to take a look at several angles. Now remember, he's seeing the same thing we are, and he needs indisputable video evidence to overturn the call. Well, they get it right after the review. They call it a catch, and play will continue. It's first and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Looks left, finding his tailback. He's taken down around the 31-yard line. So with one quarter remaining, Florida leads 24-20. Great three quarters of action, tight ball game, and now it's the fourth quarter, and this will decide it. Under pressure, going for it all to the end zone. And that is an absolutely huge turnover for this defense. They couldn't have picked that off at a better time.
Just a horrible decision by the quarterback trying to force that pass, especially at this point in the game.
From their own 20-yard line, first down. Florida holds a four-point lead. Makes the catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. Toss across the middle, and they make the stop at the 28. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. And he was able to pick up some nice yards on the return. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Gets out to around the 45. Great job by the running back, and that's a gain of 9. Positive yardage. The lineman got a little ahead of the snap count. Here's the call.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
So the penalty will make it first and 15. Makes it out to about the 36. He tackles him for a loss.
Good discipline here by the defense, stringing the option out and plugging the running lanes. That moved him back.
It's third down and long, and losing by a possession, I would expect them to have to go to the air. He flings it. Caught, open field. They'll bring him down right around the 10-yard line. I got you, 88. give to the tailback. He makes it out to maybe the 7-yard line. He's pushed out of bounds at the 4-yard line. Touchdown, and they take the lead. Trying to go up by 3, they'll kick the extra point. He makes the PAT. An 8-play, 59-yard drive. And it's good for 7 points. Clemson to kick this one off. Clement from the 1. Oh, man, he took him down hard.
Well, this is a very competitive game. Just when you think one team has gained the advantage or the momentum, the other team comes fighting back, and it's going back and forth. This is almost like a basketball game.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line. Incomplete. They really need to pick up this third and long here in the fourth quarter. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. He's tackled at the 49-yard line. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
They bring him down in the backfield. The halfback took the pitch but couldn't find any running lane.
And there were no running lanes because this defense had so much penetration into the backfield. We've been lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about 4. And he hits him hard at the 47-yard line. Right now, he wants to get this kick away and change field position. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. And here comes the offense again. They'll try to make it 2 touchdowns and 2 possessions.
Well, it's one thing to have speed. It's another thing to have an idea of what you're doing and how to attack defense. And right now, these wide receivers clearly have done an outstanding job in being able to make their reads and getting out of their breaks, and the quarterback put the ball right on the money.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 20-yard line. Clemson holds a field goal lead. Knocked out of bounds at the 21. Set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. Clement is back awaiting the punt. We'll be right back. makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. He airs it out. He's hit and taken down.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
Just under two to go in the game. Hands it off. Taken down as he works the left for a nice game. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. Might have been some early movement up front.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that.
Kicks up, and the field goal is good. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 24-yard line. Here we are late in the fourth quarter in a very important and a very tight football game. And who's going to come to the forefront? Let's see who's got the most leadership. Brought down at the 35. He airs it out. Doesn't get there. Not enough strength on that pass, and it hits the turf.
Oh, boy, he wishes he had that play to do over. Could have been big yardage there.
From their own 35-yard line, it's second down. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Well, the player of the game might come from the defense after that stop here late in the fourth quarter. That could be the turning point. Certainly, they don't have the return on here. Heading for the corner, and down he goes at the 28-yard line. This senior quarterback's put on a good show, Kirk.
Well, Brad, you just said it. He's a senior quarterback, and that experience is so important. It allows you to just sit back and comfortably read the defenses and then eventually find the man that's open and deliver the football.
The only satisfying end of this game would be for him to lead his team to a win, however they get it done. Late here in the fourth quarter now in a tie football game, and it looks like, barring another score, we might be headed to overtime. Pass complete and taken down immediately. It quickly, and he's hit before he can go anywhere. And that's the way you're supposed to play pitch and catch.
Absolutely. You know, this wide receiver is a difference maker. He's one of those players that has a chance to go the distance every time you get him the ball.
Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. From the 15-yard line, it's first down. He makes it to the 15-yard line. So he decides to hold on to it, and it goes nowhere. The Gators use their second timeout. The kick is away. And that gives them the lead.
I know that I call kickers head cases, but this kid isn't one. It's like he doesn't even feel the pressure.
And this one's all but wrapped up. The Gators take this one, 30-27. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.